Reverend Sean David Coleman at Liberty Baptist Church, where Reverend Darrell Jackson is the pastor, Pastor Andrew D. Hunt Jr. will be preaching today. Don't touch that dial. Go to us on Channel 36 CAN TV. You stream us, YouTube us. Don't touch that dial.
Presidents, Albert T. Bland, Samuel Hartz, Lucille Smith, Thomas Tennant, Percy Proctor, George Williams, Reuben Power, Andrew Jackson, Curtis Burrell, Joseph Beard, Christine Rogers, Lee Russell Porter Sr., Dovie Ray Anderson, Lois L. Jackson, Clarence L. Thomas, and today, current President Ruby M. Yarbrough. Through the guidance of our first president, Albert T. Bland, the Ursa Board of Liberty Baptist Church joined the Unit Church Ursa's League, Chicago Zone. Two of our past presidents, Andrew Jackson and Lee Russell Porter Sr., served as president of this organization. Many of our senior and youth members also serve in active roles. Many of our ushers have gone on to become deacons and trustees of this great church. A few of our members were the first supervisors of the official greeters of Liberty Baptist Church. Our first female president, Lucille Smith, founded our annual tea. Today, this remains one of the events that allow us to fellowship and dine with members of Liberty Baptist Church, sister church, visitors, and friends. We are blessed to have three Ursa Board members from the old Liberty Baptist Church, 56 East 46th Street. They are Johnny Mae Burks, Josephine Morris, and Corrine Porter.
Amen.
And I might add that Sister Porter could not be with us, and she is now 101 years old.
Amen.
The deacons currently assigned to our organization are Deacon Preston C. Smith, Jr., and Deacon Clarence L. Thomas.
Amen.
Our youth usher board, led by Toy Stringfellow and Deborah Stringfellow, we continue to be a vital and wonderful part of our usher board family. Now in our 91st year, through the leadership of our current senior board president, Ruby M. Yarbrough, we continue to strive to maintain our vocation of Christian service, noting that we would rather be doorkeepers in the house of the Lord than to dwell in the tents of the wickedness. Psalms 84:10. I present to you the Senior Usher Board of Liberty Baptist Church, celebrating 91 years of service.
Amen.
the annual sermon. Amen. Of our Ursha Board. Glad to be a part of it. Glad to have, of course, our son in ministry, Pastor Andrew Don Hunt, and Transformation Church. I see some members are here, along with the Evangelist Crump and Dr. Donald Crump. South Park Baptist Church is here. We'll be here with him a little bit later.
Amen.
And we're going to move along now. I have a scripture to read, and then Minister Philip Brain will offer prayer. Coming out of Romans, the 8th chapter, one of my favorite passages of scripture. Amen. And I always tell people, if you just need some encouragement, read this passage of scripture. It will give you what you need. Beginning at the 31st verse of that 8th chapter, what can we say about such wonderful things as these? If God is for us, who can ever be against us? Since God did not spare his own son, but gave him up for us all, won't God, who gave us Christ, also give us everything else? Who dares accuse us whom God has chosen for his own? Will God? No. He is the one who has given us right standing with himself. Who then will condemn us? Will Christ Jesus? No, for all, he is the one who died for us and was raised to life for us and is sitting in the place of the highest honor next to God, pleading for us. Can anything else separate us from Christ's love? Does it mean he no longer loves us if we have trouble or calamity or persecution or hunger or cold or in danger or threatened with death? Even the scripture said, for your sake we are killed every day. We are being slaughtered like sheep. No, despite all these things, overwhelming victory is ours through Christ who loved us. And this is what I really love, beginning in the 38th verse. I am convinced that nothing can separate us from his love. Death can, and life can, the angels can, demons can, our fears for today, our worries about tomorrow, even the powers of hell can't keep God's love away. Whether we are high above the sky or deep in the deepest ocean, nothing in all creation will ever be able to separate us from the love of God that is revealed to us in Christ Jesus our Lord. Any Christian can stand tall after those words. And the words of the Lord and the words of the Bible are already blessed. Amen.
Amen.
At this time, Philip Brain will come and offer prayer. Brother Phil?
Amen. Amen. Let us pray. Oh, Heavenly Father, right now, we thank you for your grace and your mercy.
Yes.
We thank you for this combined ushers. Board, 91st Annual Sermon, we thank you for allowing us to come. Father God, Jesus, we thank you for your grace and your mercy. We thank you for this church. We thank you for our pastor. We thank you for the speaker that's going to speak on this evening, this afternoon. We ask that you bless him to speak well. We ask him bless him to speak what you will have him to speak. Say what you will have him to say so that everyone here will get something out of your word this afternoon. Now we thank you and make this 91st sermon, usher sermon, a successful afternoon. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. To introduce the MC for this 91st annual sermon, we're going to call on Sister Sharon Graham. Show your love at this time. Amen.
She immediately immediately became active with the Intermediate Usher Board under the supervision of Ernest Haynes Hunter. One of the supervisors at that time, she spent many Saturdays during her teenage years reviewing signals and protocols. Elizabeth continues to be active at Liberty. She is a member of the trustee board, assistant financial secretary, budget committee member, public relations committee vice chair, and nurses health ministry corresponding secretary. Elizabeth is the only child of Nathan and Minnie McKenzie. She and her husband, Edmund, will celebrate their 21st wedding anniversary this year.
Amen.
Elizabeth enjoys organic gardening, reading, and various physical fitness activities. She tries to live her life emulating one of her favorite songs, This Little Light of Mine. This is Elizabeth McKenzie Carter.
Amen.
He's like a son to me. As well as the younger brother. Relationship between the Johnson and Jackson family go back many years. His grandmother was a faithful member of this church. I was his mother, matter of fact, and my brother, my older brother, they went to Hirsch High School together. They were like brother and sister. And I always called Charlotte my play sister, his mother. I was in his parents' wedding, amen, when they got married. I know Andrew, Pastor Hunt gets tired of me saying this, but I held him in my arms when he was a baby, Dr. Crump, amen. I'm telling my age, but I don't mind telling it, amen. I was blessed when I became pastor after my father passed. And of course, Andrew's dad was one of my father's assistants back in the 70s and 80s before he got his own church. After I became pastor in 1994, I was installed November 13th that year, the following month. Pastor Andrew Hunt was the first minister I ordained as pastor of Liberty. So he goes down in the history books, amen, as the first minister ordained under Pastor D.L. Jackson. I was blessed to install him in two churches. Of course, the second church is the best church. Amen, Transformation. That's right. I told Andrew, he was in Tabernacle, I told him, I said, this is not your first and last stop, brother. The Lord has something else in store for you. Did I tell you that? I said, this is just temporary, amen. And the Lord led him to form Transformation Church. And I just turned back, I said, Andrew's about 8 years. He said, no, 10. I said, well, time really moves. He led them into their own building a few years ago. And I was there the first Sunday when they had that first service on the first Sunday in September back in 2011. That's right, 2011. I knew it had been 5 years ago. I was pastor the church. That's right. You pastor the church 5 years in. Right on the side of Gwendolyn Brooks High School. Amen. He's doing great things in the Roseland area. Amen. Reaching out to the community. He has a good church, good people. I'm out and about, and the members of the church are going to tell me, I'm a member of your son's church. And I had to ask him, which son? I got another son's in ministry now. We have another son's in ministry. But it's a translation. I was like, yeah, Pastor Hunt. And so when the urchins told me, said, coming from President Ruby Alvarez, he said, Pastor, can you ask Pastor Andrew Hunt to come back and bless us for our annual sermon? Andrew did not hesitate. He said, I'm sure I'm free on that Sunday. If there's a problem, I'll let you know. And he didn't call me back and didn't know he couldn't make it. So he's here. And Ruby said, can he bring his pie? There's fries here. And some of his members are here. Amen. We have a great relationship. Transformation Church, Andrew will be back for my anniversary in August, and I'm going out for his anniversary, his pastor, amen, later on in the year. And so we keep this fellowship going.
Thank you, Mr. McCray, for letting us define what Ever Ready is. You're the first. You're the original Everett. We thank God for Kenny Pat on the drums. Those who had it, you all know how it is to be now. Rough 2 weekends at Transformation, Saturday funerals, Holy Week, and all of that. And so I thank God for those that have managed to brave the elements and come out here today. The Mills of Transformation, just wave your hand at me. So there's a word from the Lord today. Reverend Coleman, I believe that was divine providence that you played. He can work it out. So I want you to stay close to that. We won't be long today. There's a word from the Lord in your theme. Philippians, the 4th chapter, verses 4-7. We thank God for Chairperson Holzblau. We thank you, Sister Susie. We thank you, Sister Yarbrough, for this invitation once again. It's good to know that you love. I preach today, you know, don't take for granted that you have an opportunity to stand. Just stand. Amen. We thank God that you all, the ushers, have invited me back once again. It goes without saying, I think all of y'all know how tight me and Pastor Jackson are. Amen. I will fight you over Pastor Darryl Jackson. I ain't lying, I will. And so we thank God for that relationship. Philip and I have become good friends over the past year or so. He's been doing work for me. So it's an honor to be here with Reverend Brain here and my very dear friend, Reverend Donald Crump, is here today. God bless you, man. So I'm at home, so it ain't like we got to go through all this if I'm at home. Am I right about it? And since I'm at home, I can preach about 12 minutes and y'all won't be mad either. And I'll make sure I give you 30 the next time and round it out, be 20 minutes apiece, all right? But y'all gonna have to excuse me if the Spirit says something different. Because we just want to praise the Lord today. In your thing, Philippians 4, verses 4-7, these words are faithfully recorded. Rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I will say, rejoice. Let your gentleness be known to everyone. The Lord is near. Do not worry about anything, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Let the church say, amen.
Amen.
Out of that 6th verse, do not worry about anything, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. I want to talk this afternoon from your theme, the power of prayer. Don't worry about anything, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your request be made known to God. Deacon Bertha Blair from West Point, I'll see you over there. All right, my first usher invitation came from Sister Blair over at West Point. The power of prayer. Let us bow our heads for a word of prayer. Dear Lord, we thank you for today. We thank you for 91 years. I ask that you encourage the Heart of Liberty right now. That you let them know that institutions don't last 91 years without the testimony that if it had not been for the Lord on their side, oh, where would they be? We specifically, Lord, thank you today for this 91-year tradition of being a doorkeeper in the house of the Lord.
Yes.
We thank you for these 91 years. Lord, we ask that you prepare us for 91 more. And now, Lord, let the words of my mouth not be of my own understanding nor my opinion. Lord, may they fall fresh from you. And someone may be transformed by the renewing of their mind. This indeed is our prayer. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
The power of prayer. This afternoon's text finds us with Paul writing to two ladies in the ministry. I want you to go home and read it for yourself. Two ladies named Euodia and Syntyche. He's asking them, if you will, to come together and be of the same mind. Because there is some conflict between them, but he loves them. He loves them so much that he wants those that are hearing his words to remember how they struggled with him in ministry. And as he's telling them to hold on and support Euodia and Syntyche, we find that in the fourth verse, he takes a theme of direction in their support. In their midst of supporting the ministry, Paul gives them specific guidelines that will allow them to be the support that they need to be. And for 91 years, the usher board has been seeking to be the support of the church that the church needs it to be. And not only the usher board, but every auxiliary in the church ought to be concerned with providing service to support the pastor and the endeavors that God has called him to do.
Amen.
And so, in his explanation of what he should do, he tells them to rejoice. But in verse 6, he takes a turn, because I can imagine that and any time you service God, there is some worry. You haven't really served God if he hasn't taken you to a place where you worry. Any time when you serve God, there's going to be some sleepless nights. Anybody know what I'm talking about? Any time when you serve God, there are going to be some Judases that are seeking to stab you in your back with a smile in your face. And there's plenty of things to worry about if you're not careful. Any time you're doing service to people, you got to worry about their emotions from one day to the next. Are they going to be on the door this Sunday? Are they going to be on the door next Sunday? Who's here? You're going to have some worries, but in the midst of their support, seems like Paul was telling him, don't worry about all of that. Get some sleep. Look at your neighbor and say, get some sleep. Because I declare there's somebody in here that's been staying up all night long about some things that you can't do nothing about. And I would that you turn it over to God and get yourself some sleep. So he's telling them, don't worry about anything. And then he gives them a cue. He doesn't just leave them there. He doesn't just say, don't worry and walk away. But he says, don't worry about anything, but in everything. Everything that you do by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your request be made known to God. So he's telling them in many words that there is power in prayer. That there's power to cover your words. That there's power to bring you out. And what, when we think about the power of prayer, what draws us into the fact that prayer itself is so powerful? Well, if you read the text very closely, you'll find that you'll realize that when you pray, that there are two things that are going to go on for sure. Usher, when you've prayed for 91 years, those before you and those that are standing here today, the reason why your prayer was powerful is because when you pray, two things happen. One thing is the precursor of verse 6. The Lord is near. See, prayer is powerful because when you pray, you call on something that is bigger than yourself. When you pray, you do what the old folks say, you take your burdens to the Lord and you leave it there. When you pray, you invite the Holy into the room so you can have a Holy Ghost party. When you pray, you find the tears will roll down your eyes, and you can come and find yourself in the presence of the one who is able to keep you from falling. When you pray, you don't have to worry about the phone line being too busy when you pray.
Look at you, say.
set it straight. But in the midst of him setting that thing straight, I know, maybe I'm talking to somebody that ain't never been through nothing, but I believe me and Sister Tillman at least have been through something. And when you go through something and God puts that thing together, in the midst of him putting that thing together, guess what other power they promise you? That he'll keep your heart and mind. He'll keep you preserved through that thing. He'll make sure that you can walk through that thing. He'll make sure that you can live and resist in that thing. He'll make sure that this God that you can get some sleep.
That's
power.
Yes.
And pray. Real prayer. When you drop it and you turn it over to him. See, some of us turn it over and we pick it back up. We try to do what God has already done. That's the big saying in my household. That there's some things we just need to let God handle. We need to leave that thing there because we're not strong enough to pick that stuff up ourselves. There's some things you're going to face in life that you, and it's not talking, I'm not talking about being lazy. I'm talking about understanding your limitations. You got to understand that he is bigger than each and every one of us. And there's some stones in our life that can only be moved by the presence of the Lord. Amen. So see, y'all know I really understand now. You can't make folk do nothing they don't want to do.
Amen.
Pastor can't make nobody give what they ain't already determined that they don't give. They just don't break it up. But what you got to do is stand in the midst of that thing. Know that through the midst of those trials, he'll keep you. And so also we celebrate you today because God is a keeper. I don't know if he's going to give you everything that you want, but I know that he'll keep you. I don't know if you're going to be rich, but I know he'll keep you through the drought.
And when God moves in the Yeah.
gave us a good word. He gave us a good word, not just for us, but for all of us. I can't help but think, amen, on something the second president of our convention, the Progressive National Convention, said a number of years ago. I believe we were in Charlotte, North Carolina. And Mama Dotson Ross, he said, "You preachers, if you're invited somewhere to preach," I know Crump heard it, he was there. He said, "Always speak to the occasion." He said, "If you can't speak to the occasion, don't accept the invitation." Amen. And Dr. Hunter spoke to the occasion, didn't he? Amen. I knew he could. Amen. I knew he could do it.
Offered a helping hand, afforded words of encouragement, or or said a prayer, I express my heartfelt gratitude of appreciation. The one element that has allowed this usher board to endure for 91 years refers back to our designated thing, the power of prayer when in service. This continuous prayer has been the glue that has sustained the foundation that was nurtured and matured by previous and present board presidents. As we still have much of God's work to do, we solicit your combined support and prayers. God bless each of you as we move forward as servants in Christ. We thank you, God.
Good afternoon, once again.
Good afternoon.
I'm not going to read what I put in the program as far as the thank you, but I want to just take time to, first of all, Pastor Hunt, thank you, thank you, thank you. Elizabeth, we want to thank you for taking